don't.
Me either.
What a piece of crap.
The worst. Manny, I can't direct this play. You've got to get me out of it. Because I've had second thoughts, that's why. Because it stinks, that's why.
I can't believe they got Vivian March to star in this thing. I thought she was dead.
But she will be.
Someone told me Vivian March's agent is producing it. And I heard she sunk a lot of money into it, too. And have you ever heard of this playwright, Gaylord Wilson?
No, but I bet he thinks he's the next Tennessee Williams.
Yeah, I bet he also thinks he has talent.
I know the last three stunk, too. Because this one stinks on ice.
I'm glad the final auditions of the day, this script was starting to stink up my apartment. I had to spray Lysol.
How can I return the advance on my salary? I spent the advance. Why would I ask for an advance if I didn't need to spend it?
Either of you reading for the part of the son?
No.
Well, then I gotta narrow it down to me and him. I'm a shoo-in. I don't think they're gonna give that part to that kind of a guy, you know what I mean? They're gonna need someone a little more virile, like me.
How long have you been in the theater?
Long enough that I can spot one of them across a crowded room.
Well, then you'll have to excuse me. I'm going across the room.
Nah, he didn't mean.
I think he meant.
Manny, listen to me. I'm not going to my own theatrical funeral.
The actors are starting to show up.
Hold on, Manny. That's fine, Bernice.
I just love show business.
That's nice, Bernice. Manny,
is
look.
Is there anything I can get you, Mr. Redmond?
Aspirin. Manny,
regular
I...
Regular or extra strength?
Extra strength.
Two
Manny.
Or three?
12.
What a riot. You kill me. 12. I love this business.
Manny, help me.
God, I'm out late. What time is it?
It's only 5 till. Keep your skirt on, lady.
I was planning to, so don't get any ideas.
Colleen?
Chris, is that you?
Oh. Oh, how's Bill?
There's no more Bill.
Is he dead?
I should be so lucky. No, we're just divorced. How's Michael?
Well, fine. We're still together. It's been 5 years.
Well, at least one of us found Mr. Wright.
I was lucky. He is. Oh, I'm dying.
Hey, Bill, look, I was just kidding. I mean, I knew all the time. It was just a joke, you know?
Hey, what's the matter? I mean, don't you people have a sense of humor?
hold on, man. Thank you, Bernice.
I knew you wanted 2, but you said 12. You kill me.
Yeah, I'm a host.
Is there anything else, Mr. Ed?
Yeah, get coffee for everybody.
Where should I go for it?
Brazil.
Brazil! I love it!
Hi. Am I late? Colleen Reed? Colleen Reed!
Do I know you? No, I don't think so.
But I know you. In 1978, you starred in Barefoot in the Park at the Cleveland Playhouse.
That's right. How'd you know that?
I was there. My mother took me.
Your mother.
All right, Manny. You've convinced me. I'm stuck.
Excuse me, sir. Might this be the Brown House Theater?
I've got to go, Manny. Tennessee Wilson just showed up. Gaylord! Gaylord, have you thought about rewrites?
Oh, it's word perfect!
Are you in this play? I'm, reading for it.
Really? So am I. What part?
The daughter, Dixie Lou.
So am I. I might as well just turn around and go home if you're reading for the part, too.
I'll call you a cab.
But how did the gardener get into the bedroom?
He climbed up the vine.
But why would he?
Don't argue with me. That's the way it happened in life.
Oh, right this way, sweetheart.
done.
She wants to get her nails done. Let's not take all day with this, okay?
Whatever you say, Bill. She's the boss. I mean, you're the boss.
Thank you.
Gaylord. Oh, I read your play again last night, and I wept again.
Oh, yes, me too. I cried like a baby.
And it's a wonderful play.
And of course, it's worth piety.
Look, I want to apologize for snapping at you when I first came in.
That's okay. Everybody's a little uptight.
I'm going through a period of hating men.
Then you should like most of the guys around here.
Where's Vivian?
She's getting ready to make her entrance. Where's Gaylord?
We had a minor tiff. He's keeping a merciful distance.
How'd you like my niece? Didn't I tell you she'd work out?
She's great, Phil.
Where is she?
I sent her out for coffee. She should be back in October.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Everyone want to line up, please? Now, this will be, we hope, the final callbacks. By the end of today, we should have a complete cast. Now, you've all been asked back to read specific parts, but don't be thrown if we ask you to read another part to help us out. Gaylord, did you want to say something?
Mercy, it's warm in here!
Our producer, Phil Zwicker.
Oh. Hello. I'm privileged to be able to present this wonderful, tender, passionate, and moving drama to Broadway. And I'm sure you'll all be as proud as I am to be associated with it. Our plan is to open 4 weeks from today in Boston, then 4 weeks in Philadelphia, then 7 years on Broadway.
You'd all live so long, Phil.
That's the spirit. I'm happy to tell you that the star of this play will be reading with you today. That great lady of stage and screen,
I loved her movies,
will be making her triumphant return to the stage after much too long an absence.
Big star, not
ladies and gentlemen, Miss Vivian March.
Whose in the hell bicycle is this?
Oh, it must be mine. I knew I should have taken the subway.
My God, my nails, I'm damaged. Thank you so much.
I'm sorry, Miss March, that was my bicycle.
You ruined my entrance. Don't ever let it happen again.
No, I won't.
Have we hired him yet?
No.
Good.
Oh, and this is my secretary, Bernice.
Break an arm, everybody.
She's new.
Why isn't Gaylord sitting with us? I think it's rude.
Philip, we artists must have our little peccadillos.
That's what I meant.
All right, that's everyone. If we can all retire to the wings of the green room, we'll be calling you back individually to read. We wish you the best of luck, and let's have a good time.
Okay, Douglas. Just yesterday, after months of trying, you finally convinced your mother to bury the memory of your long-lost daddy and start a new life of her own. You wanted her to find a new love, and now you learn she has. Your sister, Dixie Lou's fiancé. You are furious and want to confront her before Dixie Lou finds out. Okay?
I think so. Mother, I want to talk to you.
Oh, Boudica, I know what you're going to say, and I don't want to hear it.
This escapade with you and James has gone too far.
I can't hear you, Boudica.
My God, Mother. James is your own daughter's fiancé.
I'm not listening.
You're twice his age.
I said I'm not that's not true.
It is.
Well, so what if I am? Love is aimless. Love has no wrinkles.
But what about Dixie Lou?
Well, she can do better than James. I'm simply giving her the opportunity to do so.
I think what you're doing is shameful.
Beauregard, how can you speak to your mother like this? You make me feel faint. Oh.
Thank you.
Mr. Wilson, why are you sitting all the way up here?
Up here feels more like home.
Do we?
Don't you want to join the others in the front?
Heavens no. There are actors down there.
This is fun.
I don't think I've ever met twins, you know?
Yeah, well, I'm only half the set.
Is your brother acting in anything right now?
Oh, yeah. Now, in the last 3 years, I bet there haven't been 2 days straight where he hasn't been in a play or commercial or something.
How about you?
I haven't worked in 3 years. I don't understand it. I mean, sometimes we go together to the same audition, and Dave always gets the part over me. And I'm exactly as good.
What a shame. You're very nice.
Thank you.
You wouldn't think that I was being too forward if I suggested that maybe we go out sometime.
No, I'd like that a lot. Well, how about dinner tonight?
Oh. I meant me and your brother.
Okay, Jill. You've just seen your own mother and your fiancé together in the gazebo.
You're not sure that they were kissing. You don't want to believe that they were kissing. But the Alabama moonlight does not lie. Do you confront her now? Or do you wait? Do you speak? Forever hold your peace!
Gaylord, you mustn't upset yourself like this with every audition.
Hello.
Dixie Lee, whatever are you doing out of bed? I shall tell James that you are not following Doctor's order.
Let's talk about your bed, Mother, and leave James out of it.
You are delirious with fever, Dixie Lee.
I saw you, Mother, in the moonlight with James. Showing him your gazebo.
I'm not listening to any more talk like this. Dixie Lou, go to bed.
I won't get this part. I'm too old to play the daughter, let's face it.
Colleen, that's crazy. You can give the part a lot more depth and maturity.
They don't want depth and maturity. They want Little Miss Muffet out there.
Possibly be worse.
Thank you, darling.
It's so amazing. When I close my eyes, I can hear Mother as if it were yesterday.
Oh, thank you, Gaylord.
Of course, Mother wasn't as old as you.
Oh, Miss Reed, I was awful. I was just awful. Oh, you should have heard me. No, I'm
glad you didn't hear me. Oh, Jill. Oh, Jill, 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 Jill. You can never tell how they're going to react to an audition, what intangible quality they might be looking for and finding you. Don't worry about it, honey. But after I finished, they asked me to read for the part of the maid. Well, that's normal. They said they might ask us to read for another part. Oh. Thank you for being so nice. Oh. You really were pretty bad, huh?
But Miranda, didn't Dixie Lou tell you what the doctor from New York said?
Doctor?
About the x-ray.
Whose x-ray?
Dixie Lou's x-ray.
Dixie Lou has x-rays?
Yes, her corpuscles.
Whose corpuscles?
Dixie Lou's corpuscles.
Dixie Lou has corpuscles?
Black ones, too many of them.
Oh, catch me, James.
Thanks.
Peter.
Oh, Peter. I'm so dry.
Me too, nerves.
Before a performance, just before I'd make an entrance, I used to drink a gallon of water. Bill, my ex, used to say he could hear me slosh across the stage.
Would you, like for him to be there opening night?
Yeah. I'd send him a ticket for the worst seat in the house, but I want him there. Does that sound vicious to you?
James, my darling, you can't challenge my son, my own flesh and blood, to a duel. I love you both.
But he has accused us of actions unspeakable and impossible.
Unspeakable, yes. Impossible? Not necessary. If one of you should die, how could I ever forgive the other?
Don't worry, Miranda. Maybe we'll both die.
I feel safe.
You know who I like to look out and see opening night?
Who?
All those acting teachers and vocal coaches who advise me to stop wasting my parents' money on lessons. I'd like to teach them a lesson.
Here's to ex-husbands and acting teachers.
Why don't we try this sometime with real glasses and real wine?
Huh? Oh, no. I don't think so. I don't know. I mean, we hardly... Sure. Why not? I'd like to.
Great.
Color green, please. Next.
Yes, Mother. It's true. I have less than 6 months to live.
6 months from the first of this month to the first of next month.
I ask only one thing. That you lay me to rest under the weeping willow where I played so joyfully as a child.
Oh, I'm sorry, Dixie Lou. The willow died last year. Root rot.
Then scatter my ashes across the lily pond.
Dried up 2 summers ago.
Oh, my.
I tell you what. Let me choose a spot after you've gone. It'll be a surprise.
That's good. Thank you, Colleen. Colleen, while you're here, would you mind reading for the part of the maid?
If you want me to.
Her first appearance is on page 89.
Warren, I don't see how you do it. You're next. You don't even seem to be nervous.
Well, I've been through a lot of these things, and I know that the reading isn't everything.
That's what Miss Reed told me.
And I've lost a lot of roles simply because I refuse to sleep with just anyone. You know what I mean?
Oh, yes. No, I can't imagine you sleeping with anyone.
Believe your maid's word over mine, your own son?
Peggy is the one who's pregnant, Beauregard.
But that doesn't mean I'm responsible.
You're just like your father, Beauregard. Years ago, shortly after we moved here to Magnolia Acres, your father indulged in a lurid liaison with my maid, Gretchen. Gretchen had the baby, a little girl, right here in this very room.
Did you dismiss her?
God beat me to it. Poor Gretchen died during the delivery.
And what became of the baby?
I raised her as my own, and she grew up to be the best maid I ever had.
You mean?
Yes, Beauregard. Peggy, you have been carrying on with your own half-sister.
My God, Lord. There must be an easier way to staff a household.
Oh,
if you try it again, I'd like to take it back.
Yes, yes, I'm all right. I'm all right. You!
Dear Lord, what's the matter?
He was perfect. That was me. He brought back such memories. You.
You know, don't you? You must have suffered horribly as a child, too.
I hope he did.
Thank you, Warren. If you'll join the others now, we'll be announcing our decisions shortly.
Okay, that's it. What do we think?
Okay, people. Angela, Douglas, I want to thank you for coming in and taking the time to audition. We've got your numbers and we'll be in touch.
Sure. Dave was here, he would have had the part.
As for the rest of you, we'd like for all of you to be part of our cast.
We're well aware that this has been a long process for everyone. We thought we'd spare you one more sleepless night by telling you now about our decisions. Of course, we'll contact each of your agents afterward.
Marcus, do you mind?
Oh, I'm sorry, Phil. I lost my head. Please, continue.
Thank you. Okay, Chris?
Yeah?
We want you to play the fiancé, James.
Oh, all right!
The role of Beauregard the son was painfully hard to cast.
Painfully.
That's one reason we asked all the men to read for it. Warren? We'd like for you to play Beauregard.
You mean it? Really? Oh, this is wonderful. This is a great moment in theatrical history. Thank you, Miss Marsh. Thank you for this opportunity. I promise you won't live to regret it.
What a way you have of putting things.
Peter, we'd like for you to understudy both male roles, and we need an assistant stage manager. That's yours, too, if you want it.
Thank you. Sure. Why not?
Colleen. We'd be happy if you would understudy the role of Dixie Lou. And play the part of the maid, of course.
Well, thank you. I'll have to talk to my agent.
Sure, sure. You'll let us know soon. Jill.
Yes?
We want you to play Dixie Lou.
Oh, my God. I got the heart. I can't.
First read through on Monday. We open in 2.